Okay, my friends, here we are, another UC-15 ice maker. Just brought this into the shop the other day. Customer wants me to rebuild it, but I said, well, let's figure out what's going on with it first. So I ran it overnight, and spray pump is spraying. Let me get a light so you can see. Got a good spray. All four nozzles are working. I can see the water circulating. The blue light's on, so that means it should be cooling. So I let it run overnight. I came back the next morning. Machine was still running. No ice. And the water is warm. Well, it's cool now because it's been sitting for a while, but I came back in the morning, the water was just room temperature. So, I'm wondering if you guys know what's wrong with it before I check it out, because obviously the pump is working, so you can see the water coming out right here. It's going outside. And we're going to take this rear cover off and find out. I'm thinking just one of two things. Either it has a freon leak or the hot gas valve is stuck open, because it doesn't cycle off and on. Obviously, it doesn't make cubes. So stand by and let's see what we can figure out here. Okay. I'm back. And I was wrong. It doesn't have a freon leak, but the compressor is not running. But the condenser fan motor is running. The pump is on. The water's spraying. So we're going to check it out and see what happens. It could be just in a harvest cycle right now. We're going to wait and see. Right now, condenser fan motor is not on. So I just recently pulled the plug out. We're going to let this time out and see if this compressor gets power, because I have a feeling it could be. I mean, this is all rusted. It's very possible this overload, these things go bad quite often. So we could check this for continuity also while we're waiting for that to kick in. All right, stand by. Okay, condenser fan motor is now on. But we're not getting any power at the compressor, and we should. So now we have to look in another area. Broken wire, possibly up in the control board. See, the water filter is leaking there. I don't know if you can see that. The manifold's leaking. That's a common problem on these UC-15s. I'm going to check out the wiring diagrams to see, because I'm pretty sure that compressor should be running when that condenser fan motor is on. It's on a cooling cycle, when the blue light usually indicates that it's cooling. Okay, so let me do some more checking and I'll get back. Okay. See that blinking red light? That's usually indicative of an open fuse. So I'm going to pull the plug, pull that fuse out. Actually, we could actually check it for power. Let me get a tester. Okay, so it doesn't appear to be the fuse, because I've got 122 volts on both sides of the fuse. 122, 122. All right. Next check. Okay, so after reading the troubleshooting guide for Sub-Zero, because I hadn't run into one of these problems in a long time, that blinking red light means the control board's bad. So I do have one laying around here somewhere. I'm going to replace the board, and we'll see if that corrects the problem. Okay, so I have an extra head here. I'm going to pull out this control board and change it, and I'll show you how to do that. And first, I'm going to disconnect the power. I mean, I could just change the whole thing, but I just want to show you how to change the board. Take this off. Take this off. Take that out. This moves up there. These harnesses are different, so you see how you can mix them up. Green, white, orange. There it is. Okay, so we can start putting these wires back on. The old one. This one goes here. This one goes in here. This one goes in here. Okay, I think we got as one more here. Where'd it go? There it is. There it goes. That goes in here. Like that. Okay. Let's see what happens when we plug it in. Red light's not blinking. Okay, let's let that run for a bit. This is also how you change the interface in here. It's right there, but you got to take this whole thing. You've got to take these screws out and get this thing out, but it's not that bad. So now you know how to change a control board on a UC-15. So let's just let it run and let it kick in, and we'll check it again. You see that light on? We got power at the compressor. Okay. More problems here. This compressor is kicking out on an overload, and it's drawing in way too many amps. Wait for the compressor to kick back in. So, there you go. 13.6562. It's drawing 13 amps. This compressor is seized. Alright. Not much we can do here anymore. I'll have to talk to the customer about it. In the meantime, I hope this was helpful. Help you diagnose this machine. Machines like this. Okay. Okay, folks. The prognosis, compressor, control board, water manifold, water filter manifold. I contacted the customer. I gave her an estimate and told her it was probably half the price of a new machine. So we're waiting for her to let me know what she wants to do. And if she wants to go ahead and fix it, then I'll include that in this video. If she just says scrap it, then we're done. So hope some of this information was helpful. At least you can know how to change a board. The manifolds, we've got videos on that, and the compressors are pretty standard, except that this is a special compressor in the sense that it's, first of all, has a start cap on it, and it's a 650 BTUs, and it's a small 1/5 horsepower, so you can't use a regular 1/5 horsepower compressor in there. You have to use the one that was intended for this machine. Alright, so that's it for now. I'll post this video. If she says no, don't fix it, so at least you can gather some information from it. See you next time. Okay, my friends, last part of this video, I spoke to the customer and she's in agreement with me and said that it's probably not worth putting that much money into the old machine, so she's going to get a new one. Alright, so that concludes this video, and at least now you know how to change the board, control board, and how to diagnose a bad compressor. I didn't show you the manifold, but the manifold was leaking, and it's really common on this particular machine, the filter manifolds, where the filter goes in the back. So that's not so bad of a fix, but when you incorporate the compressor and the board, too much money. You can almost buy a new machine. All right, we're going to see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.